Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I'm glad you could join me. My name is Lonnie, and in this video, we're going to talk about a bedroll. You've probably heard about bedrolls. You've probably seen them in old Western movies here in the United States. Perhaps Canadian trappers, and they've used them in other countries as well. Well, if you've ever slept underneath of a wool blanket like I have, perhaps you discovered the same thing I did, and that was I froze. I froze bad. I didn't take anything with me but this wool blanket here, and I was freezing the whole 3 days or so. But the reason why is I didn't know how to use it. So let me show you how to use it. Let's get started. Okay, this is my blanket that I'm going to use. This is an Early's Whitney Point blanket. This is a Hudson Bay type blanket, but actually this company predated Hudson Bay. They've been trading for over 300 years, but that's really not important. It's a 4-point blanket. It's about 7 feet by 6.5 feet. And a very thick wool. So let's lay it out. Okay, now, first of all, our setup here, I've got a insulated inflatable mattress here that I'm gonna be sleeping on and that I'll be laying on. And you will need insulation from the ground. That's important. Too many people forget to insulate from the ground, and you're gonna lose as much heat through the bottom of you as you will through the top when the ground is cold. Okay, we've got the blanket laid out now, how we're going to use it. Now, notice, okay, we've got a canvas tarp, and this is a canvas drop cloth. So they're rather relatively inexpensive, and this is 9 by 12 dimensions. And okay, notice the sleeping pad is laid this way, and the corners, the opposing corners of the tarp, are in line with the center line of the sleeping pad, and you'll see why in a little bit. Also, the blanket is also in line with the center line of the sleeping pad. That is so that we can gain maximum length, which we'll need. All right, let's go ahead first of all, you'll see that I've got the blanket turned the opposite way from the tarp. The tarp is going this way, and the blanket's going that way. That's probably not that important, but I just did that so that when it's all folded, the seams of the tarp and the edges of the blanket won't coincide for a little bit better coverage. Now, how you use the blanket and the tarp is what is key to your warmth. So, first of all, we take the bottom corner, pull it up over the feet, and you want to lay, you want to get started where you'll be laying. So you pull this bottom corner up. Now notice, since we are working with rectangular fabrics rather than square fabrics, there will be a lower corner and a higher corner. One side will be lower than the other. Okay, so we'll take the lower corner first. Now notice I run these edges out to where they're flat, straight across more or less. And the reason for that is when we flip this over, it'll give us better coverage on the feet. We've now got 1, 2, 3 thicknesses over our feet. Okay, now we'll lay down. make sure that the blanket is stretched out, and we'll pull this up and tuck it under ourselves. Okay, you'll want to tuck it under real good so it isn't all balled up underneath of you. Okay, now just like we did on the lower corner, we're going to do the same thing on the upper corner. We're going to flip it over. You may not be able to get this upper edge down, this upper corner down is on your feet as low due to the, you know, the angles here, but get as best you can. We now have 5 layers over our feet, which will help to keep our feet warm. Now once again, lay back and stretch the blanket up real good and tuck this underneath of you. All right, now it's time to start in on the tarp. We're going to do the tarp the same exact way. Bring the bottom up. Okay, now you noticed, I should have explained it earlier, but you noticed the blanket was laid pretty evenly across your sleeping area, with an equal amount below the sleeping area, equal amount above it. You'll want it roughly the same with the tarp, but since the tarp is larger, maybe favor a little bit towards the bottom, moving the sleeping area more towards the bottom. But you still want plenty of overlap. Okay, we pulled the bottom up over us. Stretch it up here real good to get maximum insulation. And flip this, the lower corner, over first. Tuck it under. Lay back. Okay, I'm just going to tuck edge of that under and leave this out here. This will come over the top of us with this edge of the tarp. Now again, try to get it over your feet as best you can. Okay, now notice, I'm sure you notice, we are using a blanket. How good is this? What kind of temperatures is this good for? Well, that's entirely up to you, your body type, and the quality of materials that you're using. You know, how thick your blankets are, how thick your tarp is, and how warm you sleep or how cold you sleep. So, you know, that's an answer I can't give you. For me, this is probably good down into the 30s or 40s, probably upper 30s with this one blanket. I may not sleep real comfortable like I do in my bed at home, but you know, it'll be adequate. Now if you need it for colder temperatures, just add another blanket or 2 blankets or 3 blankets. Just add however many you need. If you need to ask how heavy this is, then I'll probably say, I'll just have to say then this probably isn't for you, because This is not light. It is definitely heavy and it is bulky. This is more appropriate for somebody who is transporting this by an all-terrain vehicle, an off-road vehicle, or a boat, or a horse or something. This is definitely not for backpacking. Now, getting back to how warm this is, a sleeping bag would work just as great inside of here as a blanket. Use a sleeping bag and then fold the tarp over it, just as we're doing with the blanket. Now, to continue on, you'll want to make sure that your blanket is sufficient, of sufficient size and position, so that you can tuck up into it and it'll cover over your body real well up around your head. It'll cover your shoulders and cover maximum part of your body. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach up above me, grab this, flip it over me to cover me up. Now before I do that, I want to explain. I see a lot of people make the mistake of breathing. They'll, like in a sleeping bag, they'll get down in the sleeping bag and breathe in the sleeping bag, which that really warms you up nice and fast. But it's putting a lot of moisture into your sleeping bag. And in the end, especially on a multi-day trip, you're gonna really compromise the insulating abilities of your bedding, since it'll have all that moisture in there from your breath. That is the beauty of a system like this, is you're not breathing into your bedding, into your, you know, the core of your insulation. You're just breathing into the canvas. And if your canvas is waterproofed, it makes it quite weatherproof, quite wind resistant as well as rain resistant. So I'm going to flip this over my head and then I'm going to rearrange the blankets. So, good night. This is a warm setup. Now, something I didn't explain is if you're having problems holding your blankets together, you have to get in there and you get it all situated and arranged and you're rolling and tossing. If your blankets tend to come apart, you can use one of these. It's called a blanket pin. They come in 3-inch, 4-inch, or even 5-inch, and they're relatively inexpensive. So you can use them to pin your blanket together. After you've flipped the canvas over you, your canvas top, so that you're weatherproof, you can also pin that down if you have a little bit of breeze. Now it may look like I'm wrapped up here pretty tight, and you know, it'd be hard to get out of here if a person had to real quick. But in reality, it's not much worse than trying to find a zipper on a sleeping bag and getting it unzipped. I'll show you. There you go. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And we'll see you on the next video. You guys take care.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.